Let's get into them with employment and hiring expert Chris Lawson. Good morning, Chris.
Good morning, April and Stefan. How are you?
Good. Before we find out what you should do, let's talk about what not to do. Give us some of the weirdest of the weird, because these almost sound fake. They're so comical.
They really are. It's but, you know, people are strange, right, sometimes. And, you know, some of these examples that really stand out, a lot of people will still use a cover letter. And in the cover letter, we've seen some kind of crazy things. In this particular example, individual talked about her family being in the mob in the cover letter, which was it's a little extreme there. Might be a little scary. You know, what do you do with the resume? And then, of course, someone had decorated their resume with pink rabbits. These are things that people have actually done, and it's it's crazy. You know, creativity is one thing, but taking it to the extreme is probably not going to help.
Yeah, I mean, if you looked at this from, say, a pie chart, I bet you have a very small slice that of applicants, say, looking for a job that do it 100% correctly. I bet you there's a big part, though, that maybe the most disturbing for would-be hire, or, you know, the employers that are looking for people, and that would be just little things, a typo, mm-hmm. maybe a wrong title. I mean, still people are doing that, even in a very tough work environment, I would imagine.
They really are, and you see this a lot. I mean, you really do. That people will put that their attention to detail is so great, and then you won't get past the summary or the objective, and you've got a typo or you've got something on the resume that demonstrates that lack of detail, even in the most important thing. Yeah. You know, your one opportunity to get in front of somebody. And you've got some errors, so you have to really be careful with that stuff.
I like the candidate who listed to make dough as an objective on his resume.
Yeah.
I think the ultimate goal for a lot of these folks, like the mob girl or these other people, or the person who said, sing my resume to the tune of the Brady Bunch, I think they're trying to stand out, right? And that is a good thing, but how do you stand out in a positive way?
Right. Well, they are. They're trying to that, or they're just, you know, if they're wanting to sing to the tune of the Brady Bunch, they may be just about half crazy. But
yeah.
I think really to stand out, you just have to be sharp about what you're doing, and you have to clearly define what you're looking for that aligns with the job description. I see so many times that someone will be applying for an accounting position, let's say a staff accountant or senior accountant, and their objective is to find a position in sales where they can use their outgoing personality to be out and about. And it's just little things like that where instead of just blanket blasting your resume with a specific objective or tailored to, you know, it's geared towards something specific, really pay attention to the job you're applying for and who you're networking with and things like that. That those little just things, attention to detail, and the quality will really help in the long run for sure.
Chris, we appreciate the advice, and hopefully somebody will take that and not put the pink rabbits on their job application. We appreciate it, Chris. Chris
you
Lawson
bet.
With...